Well,
okay, go big.
Dear Mr. Biden, if you do not push your party using either carrots or sticks, which you have available many, if you don't start pushing them to end the filibuster, to start passing legislation, end of next year, you are handing the House and or the Senate to the Republicans. And if you don't take these steps, I have to believe that you and a bunch of top corporate Democrats do not want these policies to pass. You're just telling us you do so that everybody will love you, but you don't want them. And unless you prove you do, I will keep telling people you don't want them.
Well, Mickey, that's how you started off right there. That was great. You said
that's a lot.
Yeah, that's a whole lot to say. I'm like, well, let's. Yeah, because he certainly seems to be playing. It's like he wants to lose.
Yeah. Yeah.
Okay, I think Jenny's away with her dog. Looks like okay, Talisha or Jenny, which one do you want to go next?
I'll go. Okay. Trust and believe, I did not have to write this down. It's on a constant loop in my head. Dear Uncle Joe, you're a liar. You need me to speak up? Can you hear me now?
Yeah, we were having trouble hearing you.
Okay, can you hear me? I'm good. Dear yes. Uncle Joe, you are a liar. You have not fulfilled any of the promises that you lied about on the campaign trail. I am very displeased with your administration and your lackluster vice president. I am very displeased about how you lied to get in office, yet you steadily sit there and say you're for America and America can do anything while you let people starve, you let them go without health care, and you let them go without basic freedoms. I am very angry that you have decided to uphold the race soldiers in the police forces as opposed to holding them accountable for killing and murdering people who at the very least deserve a judge and a trial. So at this point, I give you an F for your presidency. I honestly do not see the difference between you and Trump. And other than you just not going on TV and becoming a complete pig, you are still a very, very disingenuous and racist person. And I hope that at least for the next couple of years, you do the least amount of harm like I voted for you to do, because I did not expect for you to do anything. You've excelled those expectations and did less than nothing. And so here's hoping that an actual progressive will come and challenge you in the next couple of years. That way we don't have to see whatever Red MAGA has in store for us. I bid you a gadoo. Adieu. Okay.
Wow.
Signed, a very unhappy citizen.
Throwing shade. I love it.
Wow. Okay, Jenny, you go next.
Well, so you said no swearing, so my letter's very short.
Perfect.
You know, I can't say, I would have to say to whom it may concern. Right, you're not dear anybody, Mr. President. Thank you for the $2,000 checks that you promised us. It did a world of good for all of us, and for canceling student debt, that was great too. I'm free of student debt thanks to you, and Medicare for All. That was a big one. I'm really. Oh wait. These are the things you promised to do, but you have not yet done. So I guess I'm not really sending this letter anyway. I the only thing that I have to say that he did that made me happy was defeat Donald Trump. I think the rest of it is just noise.
Well, you
sincerely.
You all kept your letter short. I went the long preacher route on mine. I'm like, wait a minute.
I didn't write a letter. Like Talisha, it's been going around in my head for months.
So I wanted, before I get to my letter, because mine as a little bit of humor because I have to be me. What, like, if you could really, really talk to Biden, I'm pretty sure you would all say exactly what you just said with a couple of words that aren't allowed on this show. Pretty very certain of that. But what part of the letter would you really say? Because I know none of you are going to cut short what you would say. It would just not happen that way. So what
Biden, grow a set and make believe you're a leader.
Whoa.
I don't know if I'd even send him a letter. Biden is stuck in his ways. He doesn't want real change, just like Mickey said. And anything we've said, or even if we were able to speak to him in person, will fall on deaf ears. People hit us with a bunch of platitudes and the right words to say, yet follow it with no action. At this point, the only thing we can hope is that we don't fall into another war, we don't fall into another pandemic, and we don't fall into a massive, massive financial bubble that's about to collapse, because there will be nothing behind it other than bailing out more rich folks and poor people sinking further into the ground and the middle class being totally obliterated. So honestly, there is nothing I can say to Biden other than please hurry up and let these 4 years be over.
Yes.
Yep, that's pretty much so. I'm going to do mine. So first of all, like Jenny, I don't even feel comfortable calling you president. There's nothing that you've done that has deemed you to be president. The only reason you were ever president is because the DNC decided that you were the best one out of a bunch of other corporate Democrats. In my mind, Bernie Sanders should be president of the United States. You're never gonna make me change my mind. You pretended, or you did a really good job, which I'm gonna actually compliment you on, of fooling people for voting for you. Now, I know some people voted for you because Trump is worse, and Trump is terrible, trust me. But really, if you look at your character, you're no different than what he is. You both have rape allegations against you. You both want to increase the military budget. You're both against Medicare for all. So I really can't see any difference between you and the orange person that occupied the seat before you. I think your presidency, if you want to call it that, is a complete failure. You got COVID right, but it wasn't due to your own organization. It was due to the people that surrounded you, thank goodness. But that is very basic what you got right. Everything else you've done has been terrible. Let's start off with the $2,000 checks that never appeared. This is a pandemic, which we are still in. And yes, we do have vaccines, and yes, they seem to be working, but people are still financially struggling. So instead of being open to a monthly based income, you somehow convinced progressives that a $2,000 check was coming. So they said, oh, vote for Joe. But then a couple of days after the election, you decided, you know what? $1,400, you already got six. So I'll just make up the $1,400 and that equals $2,000. Well, sir, it does not. A $600 check is a $600 check, and a $1,400 check is a $1,400 check. And yes, they do add up to $2,000. But really, what is $2,000? $2,000 is enough to pay for what? A couple of car payments, maybe rent, maybe mortgage. If employees are giving raises to people, if landlords are deciding not to evict people, that $2,000, while I think it's not nearly enough, was at least something to say, you know what, I understand what you're going through. I'm also disappointed that there hasn't been enough talks about future monthly checks. We need a monthly income for all Americans making under, I would say, $100,000. Because really, $100,000 a year, really, if you think about it, isn't a whole lot of money. I think we need that income. I think that we need Medicare for all, but you're against it. So while you're okay with us paying for your health care, you have some kind of intellectual problem paying for mine. That makes no sense, but yes, it does, because you take money from corporate interest. So I say, I hope you lose the House. I hope you lose the Senate. And the way I'm feeling, I hope you lose the presidency, because your administration stinks. It is awful. It is terrible. I've always been taught you respect your elders, but I don't have any respect for you. Your so-called Black when convenient vice president, your cabinet, which you only got one of those right, which thank goodness you did get one right. I have no respect. I can't wait for a progressive to run against you so I can vote against you. And like I said, I hope the House is lost. I hope the Senate is lost. I shouldn't feel this way, but your presidency is a complete and utter failure. Sincerely, not yours. Boy, go home.